Welcome back. All right, we know this is not a subject that many of us like to talk about or even think about, but making funeral arrangements in advance can bring you and your loved ones some peace of mind. In fact, a lot of peace of mind. That's because burial costs can be expensive. Did you know a funeral and burial averages nearly $11,000 each? That's the average. That's why some people are choosing cremation over traditional burial due to the much lower cost. The cremation rate has risen by 35% from just a decade ago, according to the Cremation Association of North America. Savvy senior editor Jim Miller is back with some cost-saving advice about cremation. Thanks for being here.
You're welcome.
All right, we just talked about $11,000 is the average price for a burial.
Yeah.
Typically, what's the average price for cremation?
So it depends on what you get. So a real basic cremation could be as low as $600 or $700, and if you add on a lot of funeral extras, it can go up to $7,000 or $8,000. So it can be a big difference.
$7,000 or $8,000, much less than $11,000.
Yeah.
So what types of tips do you have on getting the best deal on a cremation?
Yeah. So I think you need to contact several providers, because the provider will vary greatly in cost. I was doing some research before I came up today, and I was looking at some different funeral options for cremation in Norman, and the low cost there was $900 up to $3,500 for the same thing. So there's a huge difference
in
providers.
Same
thing. Yeah. So you want to check with several providers, and when you contact them, all funeral homes provide cremation services. A lot of people don't know that. So when you contact them, you want to ask about what they call a direct cremation. This is a simple, no-frills cremation. It doesn't include embalming, it doesn't include viewing of the body, and it doesn't include a funeral. It only includes picking up the body at the place of death, taking it to the crematorium, and then providing the ashes to the family. It's a simple, inexpensive, cheap way to do that. If families want to have a memorial service after the cremation, they can do that at a church or at home or a park or wherever they want in the place with the ashes present. Now, if they want extra services through the funeral, if they want a funeral and other things, they need to ask the funeral provider for an itemized list of all the services they offer and the prices so they can pick and choose exactly what they want. Providers are required by law to be able to provide this to you. It's known as the funeral rule, if you will. So that's some tips on it. Another one is a common tip is about the urn. A lot of people think you have to get an urn if you get cremation from the funeral provider, and you don't have to do that. So when you're cremated, they provide the ashes to you in a big plastic bag, and they put it in a cardboard box. So if you want to scatter the ashes, that's plenty sufficient. But if you want to display the ashes on a mantle or in a bookcase, you would need an urn to do that. And you can get them really cheap, like an Amazon.com or Walmart.com for under $50 versus a funeral provider that might cost you $300 or $400.
Sure.
So that's another thing to think about. And then one more tip too, Heather, I wanted to tell you about, is to be able to find out pricing information, you know, as opposed to calling a bunch of providers in your community. There's a great website called parting.com that allows you to plug in your zip code and the services you want. And it gives you pricing breakdowns of all the providers in your area. So it's a simple way to be able to get that pricing information.
That is an easy tool to
use.
Yeah,
it really is.
Does anyone here in the Sooner State offer free cremation?
Yeah, they do. Actually, if you're willing to give your whole body, it's a whole body donation program to science, usually to a medical, university medical school. They will use your body for research and for teaching, and then once they're done with that, they'll cremate the remains of the person, and they'll send the ashes to the family members, usually within a year, at no cost. There are two programs in Oklahoma that accept whole body donation programs. One is the University of Oklahoma Health Sciences Center Willed Body Program. It's Oklahoma City here, and Tulsa has one called the OSU Health Sciences Center Body Donor Program. Both of these programs are great. You can call them up. They'll send you a kit of information on how the program works and answer your questions, and then you can take it from there. So it's a great way to be able to get free cremation.
Right. And another benefit of cremation is you never have to leave your loved one. If you move out of state, they're always with you. You can bring them with you.
Exactly right. Yeah.
Thank you, Jim. We appreciate it. Again, parting.com. Great tip there. And for more information on this topic, we've got it for you at KFOR.com for seniors. And you can check out Jim's website at savvyseniors.org.